You may have heard about the pared-down $1.75 trillion social spending proposal Democrats are working on right now, but you may not know how it might impact your daily life.
Problem solver Melissa Hippolyte joins us now to break down one aspect of the proposal that she's been researching in depth for months. It's child care. Melissa.
Well, Democrats argue this will help working families afford childcare, but Republicans say this is an example of Democrats trying to insert themselves into intimate family decisions. As Democrats hammer out a massive social spending bill in Washington, local Democratic Congresswoman Abigail Spanberger is right in the middle of the negotiations. Here are the childcare-related aspects of the bill she believes will pass. First, extending the refundable child tax credit. Families became eligible to receive an enhanced child tax credit each month in July of this year. And Spanberger says the bill would end the enhanced dollar amounts in 2022, but allow the pre-pandemic level payments to continue to be sent to families each month.
We've heard from people I represent across Central Virginia that this refundable child tax credit has been vital to their ability to pay for childcare or pay for preschool.
Second, free pre-K for 3- and 4-year-olds. Spanberger said the government would send money to the states, who would be in charge of implementation, and programs would have to follow certain standards.
These dollars would be eligible for families who choose to have their children in a preschool at the local community center, the local church, or the local daycare center.
Republicans oppose this. Here's Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell.
Their bill would give Democrats and bureaucrats massive new authority they could use to shape curricula and standards nationwide.
Third, the bill would provide funding to help child care providers get and retain staff.
You know, certainly around Central Virginia, we have had issues of a labor shortage as it relates to child care workers.
And lastly, the legislation would cap the percentage of a family's income they would have to pay on child care at 7%. But families would have to fall within a certain income bracket, and Spanberger said this is subject to change.
This should be a targeted program towards working middle-class families. Certainly, the cost of child care can be prohibitively expensive for many two-parent households.
Another sticking point with Republicans, who argue Democrats only want to help families where both parents work.
Has your family made a different set of sacrifices so a father or mother can parent full-time? Sorry, Democrats want to redistribute money away from your family to other households that may earn even more money.
They also argue this costs far too much.
The estimate is that all this government meddling will cost $400 billion over just the first several years.
So what about paid family and medical leave? Democrats took it out of the legislation a couple of weeks ago, but they've actually put it back in, and now they want to give folks 4 weeks of paid leave. But Congresswoman Spanberger says this may not make it into the final package. Working for you tonight in Richmond, I'm Melissa Hippolyte for CBS 6.